The king dreams he is king, and he lives in the deceit of a king, commanding and governing, and all the praise he receives is written in wind and leaves a little dust on the way when death ends all with a breath. The king dreams he is king, and he lives in the deceit of a king, commanding and governing, and all the praise he receives is written in wind and leaves a little dust on the way when death ends all with a breath. Where, then, is the gain of a throne that shall perish and not be known in the other dream that is death? Dreams the rich man of riches and fears, the fears that his riches breed. The poor man dreams of his need and all his sorrows and tears. Dreams he that prospers with years. Dreams he that feigns and foregoes. Dreams he that rails on his foes. And in all the world I see, man dreams whatever he be. And his own dream no man knows. And I too dream, and behold, I dream I am bound with chains, and I dreamed that these present pains were fortunate ways of old. What is life? A tale that is told. What is life of frenzy extreme? A shadow of things that seem, and the greatest good is but small, that all life is a dream to all, and that dreams themselves are a dream. And what is a dream but the absence of thought? And what is a dream but the life of another? That is only live in the mind. A dream is nothing. Why don't you understand? It is nothing.
Play your part.
All these stories are just myths, subjective ideas, exaggerations, dramatizations. Why did you come? We have nothing to give you. We are just actors following a script. Play your part!
Life is a dream.
Okay, you're the electrician, right? You're the one who moves the spotlight. I need you to do us a favor. Go behind the stage and the radio, turn it on. I didn't manage to turn it on. Something might be wrong with it, please. It's really important. We're depending on you.
Today's the day. This is the day we risk it all. Mr. and Mrs. Lewis, famous drama passionates, they are coming to see our play at the Goldshine Theatre. The Lewises! Their family has supported small acting companies since time immemorial. And today is our turn! That is, if everything turns out fine, of course. I have been practicing theatre since I was 6 years old, and today, us leg wreckers will rise to the top. I'm getting nervous. Is it too obvious? Maybe I should stop writing notes and continue practicing the script. I hope it goes well. Let's break a leg.
so happy. We had never had the theater for us. And from not having anything to have the whole Goldstein Theater, that's a big step right there. It is not the biggest stage, but has rooms everywhere, and having more space for our costumes and scenery is something I will take with open arms. I think the new decorations, by the way, there's a sphere. Nothing new, I know, but it's somewhat strange. Viscous and gigantic. To be honest, I don't know what play they expect us to make with that thing.
Is it even possible that the Lewis have criticized our play as excellent? No, even better. Is it even possible they have bought us the whole Goldstein Theater? I'm shocked. The Goldstein is now ours. I never would have seen it coming. Besides the theater, they have also bought us some decorations, which Helena is organizing, and some extra pounds Jeffrey has spent on books to write an original play. I always wanted to do that. If Jeff wasn't a mess and didn't throw his books around everywhere, I'm sure they're lying around here somewhere.
Who do you think you are? Stay out of the cell, Christian.
If we shadows have offended, think but this, and all is mended. That you have but slumbered here, while these visions did appear. And this weak and idle thing, no more yielding but a dream. Gentles, do not reprehend. If you pardon, we will mend. And as I am an honest puck, if we have unearned luck, now to escape the serpent's tongue, we will make amends ere long. As the puck, a liar call. So good night unto you all. Give me your hands if we be friends, and Robin shall restore amends.
You! You lit up the candles! The tenth sister will not! Be happy. You will receive your punishment. If we shadows have offended, think but this and all is mended. If we shadows have offended, think but this and all is mended. If we shadows have offended, think but this and all is mended.
Hello, is this the Arctrician? St. Geoffrey asked me to tell you he's sorry for putting you in danger when turning on a radio. God, this is dumb. He asks you to forgive him, that it was necessary, and yada yada yada. I tell you, these people are losing their minds. Speaking of which, Helena says some lights have broken down in decorations. Don't know why the state of anything matters in the particular situation we are caught in, but it seems important. She wants it fixed. Whatever. The keys for decorations are at the entrance of the theater. Thank you.
stuck in here. Apparently the Lewises took the keys to the Goldshine with them, and as they live far away, it'll be some time before they bring them back and we can get out. Bullshit! They want us here, we just don't know why. We're not completely stuck though. The Goldshine has access to the sewers of the city, so technically it is possible to get out through them. However, I met a worker from the sewers. He asked for help, shouting about something that was chasing him. Then he just went quiet, staring at nothing, then turned around and went back down. I haven't seen or heard from him since. The theatre has food too, so I would prefer to stay up here before risking it down there.
The theater enthusiast I am, I do think there are major differences among the popular written plays we are all accustomed to hear about. I, myself, consider the work of, for example, Calderón de la Barca to be profound, reflective, yet a great show overall. But if there's something I cannot stand, it's no doubt Oscar Wilde and his work. Will not waste a penny of a play written by those filthy hands, no sir. He only deserves to rot in the gutter he so much enjoys. If they look at the stars, we will look down to them.
Thank you.
Is there a giant ball at decorations? Helena has been obsessed over that lately, but I've seen that sphere a few times myself. Last time was some days ago, when Helena told us the ball was flickering black and white, which is strange, considering it had been a normal prop for the last few weeks. Helena was covering her eyes, as if the light didn't let her see, which I felt was a bit of an overreaction since it wasn't even that intense. Jeffrey also saw the sphere, and his reaction was to run away. Not in fright, not in a panic. Just turned and ran without saying a thing. I, nonetheless, do remember what I saw. I had been drinking, that's true, but I'm sure what I saw was real. Behind the light, and beneath the translucent surface of the sphere, there laid something. Something alive.
Wake up! It's lights on. Come on, you're strapped to the chair. You can't go and act as you don't know what he did. If you could, actually, the 10th sister would be less angry about how you offended her, as she's always looking for actors. But you are not an actor. You're not a shadow. You're just a viewer and a spectator. And spectators remain silent and watch till the end of the film. You try to face the divine. Such a Shakespearean ending. Passion gets struck by tragedy. Yet there is still a speck of justice that washes all the nonsensical actions of the main character. So, said the washing. We said it was a romantic thing, but this is. Someone else attempts to find the 10th sister. You wait for me here. Do not run away again.
I thought I had been clear enough. Don't get in my way, electrician. Stay out of this. Do yourself a favor. Make your way out and don't come back. Thank you.
It's not possible. The sphere, it inspired me. Each time I looked at it, its light, it took over my thoughts. Like going to sleep and then waking up on stage, acting. Scripts I've never known. Roles I've never played since I was a child. I could be frightened, but it felt so good to act without even being aware of it. And then, that explosion of forgotten memories. It let my mind flow so well, and I started writing. Day after day, I wanted to write a play. I always have! Who dared break the sphere? I need inspiration.
Come in.
saw the tenth sister commence his meal. Feast on the ones who watch the shadows dance.
No, Helena. I will not.
But why won't you? He's not a shadow, and he's actively made fun of you, my lord. He's nothing but a meaningless view.
He illuminates the stage. Without him, the play cannot proceed. Thus, he is an actor. He will not be harmed under my watch. Understood?
Yes, tenth sister.
As for worker, like them, if you want to stay alive, I need you to be useful. Stop wandering like a disgusting sewer rat.
Vermin.